Good morning, students. So you see the beautiful pictures in this slide. There is sunflower, there is fennel, there is mulberry plant. These all plants have flowers in their branches. So this one is called flower, we know that. But the group of these flowers, what are these called? What are these arrangement on the stem part is called? It is called inflorescence. So students, we are going to learn about today inflorescence. So what is inflorescence? What the word comes from? It comes from the word inflorescere, which means come into flower or begin to flower. What is inflorescence is called, how it is defined? A flowering shoot or an axis bearing a cluster of flowers is called inflorescence. So a shoot, a flowering shoot which bears a cluster of flowers in it are called or is called inflorescence, or we simply can say that arrangement of the flowers on the shoot. Arrangement, like these ones are the flowers, arrangement of the flowers on the axis is called inflorescence, and the main axis or the stalk of an inflorescence is called the peduncle. So the axis which bears the flower, here you can see that this branch, this is the main axis which bears the flower, is called peduncle. I write it here, this one is the peduncle, the main axis which bear, main axis, or we can say that stalk which bears the inflorescence is called the peduncle. Now the stalk of an individual flower is called pedicel. So what is peduncle or pedicel? This one is peduncle, the main branch, the main axis is called peduncle, and the stalk of the individual flower, when the peduncle is branched or divided into several parts like this, this one is peduncle and it is divided into several parts, this individual stalk which bears the flower, okay, this one is called pedicel. So the main axis is called peduncle, and the stalk or the branch which bears the flower is called pedicel, which bear the individual flower. Okay, this peduncle holds the all bunch of the flowers, but agar hum ek individual flower ki baat kare, so pedicel is the stalk which bears the individual flower. Now the types of the inflorescence, there are three types of inflorescence. First one is racemos and cymose, special type. There are three types of the inflorescence: racemos, cymose and special type. First of all, what is racemos? Racemos is the type of the inflorescence in which the main axis grows indefinite. So this branch grows indefinite or indeterminate growth present in the racemos kind of plant. Okay, so यहाँ पे आप देख रहे हो, ये जो मेन एक्सिस है, इट ग्रोज इनडिटर्मिनेट, डिटर्मिंड ग्रोथ नहीं है, इनडिटर्मिंड ग्रोथ है, एंड इट गिव राइज टू द लेटरल और एक्सिलरी ब्रांचेस. सो द ब्रांचेस कम्स हेयर, द लेटरल ब्रांचेस आर कॉल्ड एक्सिलरी ब्रांचेस, लाइक दिस वन. जो मेन एक्सिस है वहाँ से लेटरल और एक्सिलरी ब्रांचेस जो हैं वो ग्रो कर रही हैं. सो इट गिव राइज टू lateral or axillary flowers in an acropetal order. So these branches ultimately grow into a flower like this one. Let me change my pen. So this one and this one. Okay, lateral axillary flowers are arising from the main axis and which are arranged in an acropetal order. What is an acropetal order? Acropetal order means the youngest flower present at the apex. Youngest flower are present at the apex and the older flowers are present at the base. What is acropetal? Usmein young or old flowers present honge, but the older ones are present at the base. Niche present honge, aur jo younger flowers hain wo upar ki taraf, top ki taraf, yani ki apex ki taraf present rahenge. Next one is cymose type of inflorescence. What is cymose? It is opposite of the racemose. In this, the growth of the main axis is limited, determined growth है, ठीक है, like this one. यहाँ पर जो main axis है, ये जो main axis है, it grows इट हैज़ द लिमिटेड ग्रोथ, डिटर्मिंड ग्रोथ है एंड ऑपोजिट टू द रेसिमोस. रेसिमोस में क्या था, इनडिटर्मिनेट था, यहाँ पे डिटर्मिनेट होगा, लिमिटेड ग्रोथ है. एंड विच इज़ टर्मिनेटेड इन टू द फ्लावर, जो मेन एक्सिस है इट इज़ टर्मिनेटेड इन टू अ फ्लावर. वेयर इज इन केस ऑफ रेसिमोस यू कैन सी दैट द एपेक्स पार्ट देर इज़ नो फ्लावर, यहाँ पे फ्लावर प्रेजेंट नहीं है जो मेन एक्सिस है. ओके, विच शोज दैट इट है, इट कैन बी ग्रो फर्दर, बट हेयर इट कैन नॉट ग्रो फर्दर बिकॉज द मेन ब्रांच इज एक्चुअली टर्मिनेटेड इन टू अ फ्लावर. सो दैट्स वाई दे हैव अ लिमिटेड ग्रोथ, द मेन एक्सिस हैज लिमिटेड ग्रोथ. नेक्स्ट वन, द अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द फ्लावर इज बेसिपिटल. अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द फ्लावर इज बेसिपिटल, वेयर एज इन केस ऑफ रेसिमोज यू कैन सी दैट एक्रोपिटल ऑर्डर. So you can understand about the acropetal. Now the term for the basipetal. What is basipetal? Basipetal means the flower, the older flower are present at the top and the new flowers present at the base. ठीक है, opposite from the acropetal. Basipetal means base में जो होंगे new flowers होंगे. ठीक है, बेसिपिटल बेस में न्यू फ्लावर्स हैं और टॉप में ओल्डर फ्लावर्स हैं. लाइक दिस वन, हेयर यू कैन सी दैट जो ये फ्लावर है, दिस वन इज़ द ओल्डर फ्लावर एंड दीज आर द न्यू फ्लावर्स विच बिगिंस टू फ्लावर आफ्टर दिस वन. पहले ये फ्लावरिंग होगा, पहले ये ओपन करेगा, उसके बाद ये ओपन करेंगे because these are new and this one is called basipetal. So you can see the difference between the racemose and cymose. Racemose mein kya hoga, main axis unlimited or we can say that indeterminate growth, whereas in case of cymose there is limited growth. Why? Because the flower, the main axis is terminated into a flower. The second difference is the racemos have acropetal order or arrangement of the flowers in the acropetal order, whereas in case of cymose there is arrangement of flower in the basipetal manner. Next one is the types of the racemos. So racemos have two main type, compound and simple. Here we have the subtypes of the simple. We can study first about the simple racemos type. Raceme, spike, catkin, spadix, corym, umbel and capitulum. There are seven types of simple racemos: raceme, spike, catkin, spadix, corym, umbel and capitulum. Compound में क्या होगा, इनसे double हो जाएगा. जो simple raceme होगी वो compound form में होगी, complex form में होगी. So firstly we have to learn about the simple type of racemos. This one is the simple type of racemos, or we can see that first type of racemos, that is raceme. In this type of inflorescence, the main axis possesses peduncle. ठीक है, terminal bud present है. ठीक है, जो main axis है that is actually peduncle and this possesses a terminal bud and it is unbranched. You can see that जो peduncle है वो arise कर रहे हैं and give rise to the main axis, give rise to the lateral branches. Okay, simple, जैसे हम racemos में पढ़ा था कि एक main peduncle होगा, main axis होगी which is called peduncle and which give rise to the lateral or axillary flowers. So like this one is present in the mustard flower and reddish. So this type of inflorescence is present in mustard and reddish. Here this is the flower of mustard. You can see that there is a main branch and this one, the main axis is this and it give rise to the lateral or axillary flowers. And in the acropetal manner, what is acropetal? New flowers are at the top and older flowers are at the base. Okay, so this one is the new flower. Here you can see that new flower is there and the older one are present at the base. Next one is spike. What is spike arrangement? Spike mein jo flowers honge they are sessile and the main axis remains elongated. This is the main axis which remains elongated, but here the flowers are sessile, means without the stalk. There is no stalk is present. Okay, there is no stalk is present, means no pedicel is there. ठीक है, जो main axis है वो तो present है, but pedicel ये present नहीं है. ठीक है, so here you can see in this picture it is the flower of bottle brush, that is Calystemon. Here you can see that the flowers are sessile, there is no pedicel, main axis is present but there is no pedicel. Example of this type of inflorescence spike is Acaranthus and Calystemon bottle brush. Next one is catkin. In the spike you can see that the flowers are sessile, and in this you can also see the flowers are sessile also. But what is the difference between spike and catkin? So I can clear about this doubt, that the catkin is actually a spike like inflorescence which is present in the mulberry plant, Morus alba, shahtoot plant mein present hoti hai. And here you can see that this is the main axis, and there is also no pedicel is present, sessile flower is present. But what is the difference between the catkin and spike? This catkin have unisexual, present in the unisexual flowers. Unisexual flowers mein present hoti hai, and this one is the difference between the spike and the catkin. So in this picture you can see that Morus alba, the flowers are sessile, it is a fruit of the Morus alba shahtooth, jisko hum local language mein croon bhi bolte hain, jisko hum eat karte hain, and also present in the salix willow. Willow mein bhi is type ki inflorescence present hoti hai. Next one is the spadix. What is spadix? So here the sepal is converted. We can see that it is a flower, this one is a flower, and here the sepals are present. We all know that the sepals are green in color and the petals are colored part to attract the pollinators, but here they are, in the case of spadix, they are apetalous, there is no petal, so the sepal is converted into the petal form. The sepal is converted into a colorful structure. This one is the colorful structure of sepal, which is called spathe. Here I write it as spathe. ये जो reddish color का जो structure दिखाई दे रहा है, that is called spathe, and it is a sepal which is converted into colorful structure, and here we cannot say it sepal, we call it as spathe. And the inflorescence is present here on a thick fleshy axis. ठीक है, ये thick fleshy axis जो है, what is this? This one. It bears the inflorescence and it bears a cluster of sessile unisexual flowers. ठीक है, sessile flowers are present, there is no stalk, and the flowers are present on this structure which is called spadix. This part is called spadix, जहाँ पे flower जो है वो present है. Okay, so spathe क्या है? I hope it is clear. The colorful part of the sepal is called spathe, and the main branch which is the spadix bear the inflorescence. Cluster of flowers are present in the spadix. So why the sepal is converted into spathe? To attract the pollinators. To attract the pollinators, the spathe is converted into colorful form. Because the spadix cannot, here you can see that there is simple spadix, it is not colored and it cannot attract the pollinators, so spathe is doing that work. It is present in the maize, banana. Here this picture is of banana, you can see that two or three spathe is present in the banana. There are two or three spathe is present. And anthurium, this one is a structure of, or the picture of the anthurium. You can also see the spathe in the maize also. So this one is the spadix, where the inflorescence is present on a thick fleshy axis, is called spadix, and there is spathe also.
which is colorful to attract the pollinators. Next one is corymb. What is corymb like inflorescence? The lower flowers have longer pedicels than the upper flowers. Here you can see in this picture, the lower flowers have longer pedicels than the upper one. So this type of inflorescence is called corymb. Corymb type of inflorescence. And here you can see that the top, when you see the flowers from the top, the appearances look like a flat appearance. But when you go to the down, there is the branches or the pedicel arise from the different position. The pedicels arise from the different position, but the from the flat from the top, you can see that this one is flat because the all flowers reaches to the same level. So here you can see that in the Iberis amara candida flower, the lower one have the larger pedicels. The lower one had the larger pedicels, whereas the newer flowers or the upper flowers have the small pedicels. So this one is the corymb. Next one is the umbel. In the umbel inflorescence, all the pedicels arise from a common point. Here you can see that all the flowers are at the same level as in kind of the corymb. Corymb mein bhi sare ke sare flowers jo the wo same level pe the, aur umbel mein bhi sare ke sare flowers jo hain wo same level pe hain. But the difference is that in the umbel inflorescence, all the pedicels arise from a common point. All the pedicels arise from a common point. So this is umbel, and it is present in the coriander, it is present in the fennel, and in present in the Centella asiatica, which is the scientific name of Brahmi. So सबसे पहली स्लाइड में जो अपनी फैनल देखी थी, फैनल के फ्लावर्स जो देखे थे, सो दोज पोजेस अम्बल काइंड ऑफ इन्फ्लोरेसेंस. दिस पिक्चर इज ऑफ कोरिएंडर फ्लावर. सो हियर द ब्रांचेस राइज फ्रॉम अ कॉमन पॉइंट, द पेडिसल राइज फ्रॉम अ कॉमन पॉइंट एंड आर ऑफ द सेम लेवल पर है. न्यू फ्लावर्स जो होंगे वो एपेक्स पे होंगे, वो जो यहाँ पे, ठीक है, न्यू फ्लावर जो है यहाँ प्रेजेंट होंगे एंड द ओल्डर फ्लावर्स आर द आउटसाइड. ओके, विच इज़ द एक्रोपिटल सक्सेशन और एक्रोपिटल अरेंजमेंट ऑफ द फ्लावर. नेक्स्ट वन इज़ द कैपिचुलम. सो इन द कैपिचुलम और हेड लाइक इनफ्लोरिसेंस, द फ्लावर इज प्रेजेंट ऑन अ फ्लैट पेडंकल. व्हेनेवर वी ड्रॉ अ पेडंकल, वी ड्रॉ अ स्ट्रेट लाइन, बट हेयर द पेडंकल is changes into a flat structure. Like this one is peduncle, is changes into a flat structure, theek hai, which is called receptacle. So this one is peduncle which changes into a flat appearance, flat like structure, which is called receptacle and giving the inflorescence the appearance of a single flower. So yahan pe aapko lagta hai ki this one is the single flower. This flower is a single flower? No, this one is not a single flower, it is a bunch of flowers. So there are two types of floret are there in the sunflower. There is ray floret and there is disc floret. You can also see in this structure also ray floret and disc floret. So ye jo outside jo aapko colored part dikhai de raha hai, this one is a ray floret, and in between this brown structure, it is called द डिस्क फ्लोरेट. सो जो रे फ्लोरेट है वो उसमें जो है कोई भी जो फर्टाइल स्ट्रक्चर है, ठीक है, जो रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट है वो प्रेजेंट नहीं होते हैं. दे आर द असेसरी पार्ट्स ऑफ द फ्लावर जो कि सिर्फ अट्रैक्ट करते हैं पॉलिनेटर्स को. एंड द डिस्क फ्लावर, द डिस्क फ्लोरेट, वी कैन से दैट इट पोजेसेस द रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट. सो हेयर यू कैन सी दैट दिस इज़ द डिस्क फ्लोरेट, जिसमें आपको स्टिग्मा, स्टाइल एंड ओवरी इज सीन इन दिस डिस्क फ्लोरेट. यहाँ पे जो डिस्क फ्लोरेट है, ठीक है, एक स्ट्रक्चर है. देर आर मैनी ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर, मैनी पार्ट्स आर प्रेजेंट, ठीक है. रे फ्लोरेट के भी बहुत सारे रे जो हैं वो प्रेजेंट हैं, और बहुत सारी डिस्क फ्लोरेट प्रेजेंट है। तो अगर हम एक को निकाल कर देखेंगे तो देयर इज स्टिग्मा स्टाइल ओवरी विच इज़ द फीमेल रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट एंड देयर इज एंथर, देयर इज नो स्टेमन, सॉरी देयर इज नो फिलामेंट। जब भी हम ड्रॉ करते हैं तो हम ड्रॉ करते हैं एक फिलामेंट पार्ट एंड एक एंथर का पार्ट, मेल रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम है ऑफ द फ्लावर। बट हेयर ओनली एंथर इज प्रेजेंट एंड देयर आर पोलन ग्रेन्स ऑन दिस एंथर। सो जो डिस्क फ्लोरेट है वहाँ पे रिप्रोडक्टिव स्ट्रक्चर्स जो हैं वो प्रेजेंट होते हैं, ठीक है। और जो रे फ्लोरेट है ये जो है एक्सेसरी पार्ट ऑफ द फ्लावर है विच अट्रैक्ट द पॉलिनेटर्स एंड हेयर देयर इज नॉट वन फ्लावर, देयर इज बंच ऑफ फ्लावर इज देयर। जो हम ये पूरा के पूरे सनफ्लावर को एक फ्लावर कंसिडर करते हैं, नो देयर इज नो वन फ्लावर, देयर इज बंच ऑफ फ्लावर्स, ओके। देयर इज वन रे फ्लोरेट एंड वन डिस्क फ्लोरेट। सो एक रे फ्लोरेट है और एक डिस्क फ्लोरेट है। अगर हम काउंट करेंगे सो देयर आर नंबर ऑफ रे फ्लोरेट्स आर देयर एंड देयर इज नंबर ऑफ डिस्क फ्लोरेट इज देयर। हेयर यू कैन सी दैट एक रे फ्लोरेट है और डिस्क फ्लोरेट है, ठीक है। यहाँ पे डिस्क फ्लोरेट है और यहाँ पे रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट प्रेजेंट है, ओके। सो दिस वन इज अबाउट द कैपिस्टुलम। एग्जाम्पल है सनफ्लावर एंड मैरीगोल्ड। सो देयर इज द पेडंकल इज चेंजेस इनटू फ्लैटन्ड स्ट्रक्चर, जहाँ पे वो बंच ऑफ फ्लावर्स को इकट्ठे एक फ्लैटन्ड स्ट्रक्चर में ले लेता है, ठीक है, लाइक दिस वन, ओके। ये पूरा का पूरा फ्लैट स्ट्रक्चर जो पेडंकल है वो फ्लैट हो जाता है और यहाँ पे बंच ऑफ फ्लावर्स जो हैं इकट्ठा होके अपेयरेंस देते हैं एक सिंगल फ्लावर की। सो दिस टाइप ऑफ इनफ्लोरेसेंस इज कॉल्ड कैपिचुअलम, प्रेजेंट इन सनफ्लावर एंड मैरीगोल्ड। सो दिस वन इज द टाइप ऑफ द रेसिमोस, और वो भी सिंपल रेसिमोस टाइप ऑफ इनफ्लोरेसेंस इज देयर। नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर। सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग द वीडियो।